Hi there, and welcome to another video of measureschool.com, where we teach you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and today I want to show you how you can utilize the new Facebook pixel to build a retargeting audience or track a conversion on your website. I'll show you how to implement this marketing tag via Google Tag Manager and get the most out of this new Facebook pixel. All and more coming up in this video, so let's dive in. Now, Facebook announced a while ago that they will be changing their existing custom audience pixel and the conversion tracking pixel over to a new kind of pixel which encapsulate both, which will be called the Facebook pixel. And the major difference is that you only need one pixel or one line of code, which you then customize in order to build a custom audience on Facebook or track a conversion on your website. Now, how does this pixel look like? If you go into your ad manager of your Facebook campaigns, you can go under tools and here you will find the pixels and you have the tab, the Facebook pixel and also the conversion tracking pixel, which will soon go away. And therefore it is recommended to use the Facebook pixel here. And we can go under actions and click on view the pixel code. And here you can see the new Facebook pixel code, which consists of a base code, which you can see here. And we'll just go ahead and copy this. Now, the new thing about this code is that it actually has custom events that you can customize the code with. And these are shown down here. So we have view content, search, add to cart, and so on and so on. But there's already a default action that is implemented in the code, which is the track page view option. So if you deploy this kind of Facebook code, then every page view will be recorded, which we actually want for our custom audience to build. So all we need to do is copy this base code and go over to our Google Tag Manager and create a new tag. Then enter a name. My naming convention is usually the tool, then the purpose of the tag, which is an audience pixel, and where will be deployed, an identifier to later recognize the Facebook account itself, which are obviously made up here, but this might be important if you have different accounts connected to this one Google Tag Manager account. Now we'll go ahead and go with custom HTML tag because there is at the moment no tag template for the Facebook pixel. And we'll click on custom HTML. And here we can enter our tag that we just copied over from our Facebook account. Now there is no real modification that we need to do on this particular tag to build a retargeting audience. We just go with continue and choose the all pages trigger, which is already built in. We create this tag. And what we can do now is go into the preview and debug mode, which will put our browser in a certain state. In our page itself, which is in our case the demoshop.com, we will see a preview and debug console. And this console will tell you which tags have just fired. And in our case, our Facebook tag fired, and it also fires on all the pages where we have Google Tag Manager installed. So also on the next page, we see that the Facebook tag has fired. Now we can go ahead and publish this to all our users as a version and do a little quality control at the end, which we'll do with the Facebook Pixel Checker, which is a plugin that you can get in the Chrome extension store. And also here we see that the Facebook Pixel has successfully loaded. So our tag is now deployed on all the pages and we can go ahead and actually build a custom audience through this tag. This is all implemented. We could segment it down to specific pages or a specific amount of time that the user was on our website. And this is made possible by this simple implementation of the Facebook pixel. So far, nothing new. What about the other options that you have here in order to customize the pixel? and track custom events into Facebook directly. Well, if you look at all these different interactions, such as viewed content, searched, or add to cart, these are very specific to the website. One that is very important, which is actually replaced by this new pixel, is the purchase event. And the purchase event, once you fire this, replaces our conversion tracking pixel that we had before. So all we have to do is actually take our event code here. We'll copy this and we'll go back to Tag Manager. And what we can do is go into our Facebook audience pixel and copy it right here. Then we still need to change the name. So this will still be an Facebook pixel, but this time it's a conversion tracking pixel and it will fire upon a transaction. And now we just implement our custom action here behind the last action that we had with the track page view. Just add a line here and paste our code. Now when this code executes, it will track a page view as normal, and it will track also a purchase with the value 00 and the currency euros. Now we want to obviously customize this, and the best way to customize it is with variables. Now we already have some built-in variables right here, which I have available and which pulls directly from the data layer. If you want to know how to set this up, you can refer to our old conversion tracking video with GTM, where I'll show you how to set up this transaction total variable. But it's safe to say, now that's in the system, we can use it in our tag. All we have to do is replace the 00 here with these curly brackets, these two curly brackets, and our name of our variable, which is in our case the transaction total. The currency will change according to our store. We don't have multiple currencies. In our case, it's dollars. We go with dollars, US dollars, and we are all set. Now, the next step, we don't want to fire this obviously on all the pages, but only on our transaction page. And I've already made up a trigger with a custom event called transaction, which you can also see in the old conversion tracking video, how I set this up. So let's save this and create this tag. And again, go into our preview and debug mode. Back to our page. And this time, we obviously need to go through a transaction. So I'll add something to my cart. I will view this cart. I'll go over to proceed in the checkout and fill out the information here and place the order. And we get to our transaction page. And we can see here that our Facebook conversion transaction pixel has fired. And we can also check that up on our pixel helper, where we have our page view that fired, but also now our event ID purchase. You can even see what values were transferred to this pixel. And we see the value is 23 and the currency is USD, as we have it right here in our page. So what we can do is actually then go ahead and publish this as a version to all our users. Now, as you saw maybe before in the pixel code, we also have different other events that we could fire, such as add to cart, add to wishlist, search something, which are all custom actions that you can define in Google Tag Manager and fire this modified tag, so you get this data available in your Facebook advertising campaigns. And this data is actually very powerful because you can now optimize your campaigns towards one or the other goal, such as the purchase or the add to cart, and track how many of the people that came through your Facebook ads converted into a purchase or into an add to cart or into a search. So the new Facebook pixel gives us great flexibility of deploying only one code basis for all of our different events that we might want to track directly in Facebook. Now, if you want to get a hold of all the different tags that I just put into place in Google Tag Manager, then we have bundled them up into a tag template, which you can download at measureschool.com/Facebook Pixel and simply upload those to your account. And that's already it with this week's video of measureschool.com. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel so we can bring you more videos every week. My name is Julian. Till next time.